Welcome. Power BI just released 6 new updates. I'm going to talk you through all of them. They are extremely exciting. They are subtle, but they are so important to understand to unlock all the potential we can use with these visuals. I'm going to talk you through every one. So as always, in the description of this file, of this YouTube video, there's going to be a link and you can open up the file that I'm going to be talking through. It's going to have multiple tabs. We're going to talk through all the files. For the outline of how this is going to go down, we're going to go through about 6 sections, 6 different new features. We're going to talk about hiding inner borders, the new space between series for all the clustered charts, as well as overlap, underlap, the way you can sort and do new on features and formatting with clustered charts, as well as then the ribbon functionality. This is cool. We can now turn on ribbon functionality for all kinds of different charts, getting the details to how to format this. So if you want to make good looking dashboards, these subtle tips are what are going to set you apart. So follow along, get the file, let's get into Power BI Desktop. Let's go. All right, so here we are in Power BI Desktop. I'll turn on my highlighting deal to make this a little bit easier to see. So what we're going to have are multiple files, multiple tabs. I'm going to show you each of these. Every month they're going to release more and more features that are going to unlock formatting abilities. You need to follow along with these because it's going to ramp up your ability to just make next level Power BI stuff. You got to get in the weeds a little bit. So we're going to do that. We're going to start with multiple charts, work our way through this sucker. So let's go. First, an update is with stacked column charts. And what this update is in December, they unleashed a lot of new formatting features and functionality, but specifically for this release in the columns, there is now, when you go to the column section, there already were things in there like series explosion, space between series. You can expand these, do all kinds of cool stuff. So that's in there. But here's the first new feature. It's going to be subtle and it's about the border. So I'm going to reduce this. I'm going to bring this back to series explosion off. And this is what it was before. Previously, if you had a border, well, when you have these things stacked up, it actually made a rigid outline. If you look in the details here, the border goes all the way around and you can, you know, maybe we make it exaggerated so we can really see this thing here. 5, the width is 6. The border goes all the way around. The border goes all the way around. So what they released in February 2024 is hide inner borders. Click this. Boom, it's subtle. This goes away. It allows you to have a big chunked stacked chart without the thick border in the middle. That is a subtle thing that is important to know when you want to elevate your Power BI desktop game, dashboard game. So check that out. If you're interested to play with it as well, you'll want to have a variational kind of difference between the borders. What I mean by that is, you know, if you make your borders extremely light, you won't really see them. So typically what you can do to make it look cool is not have like a static color. What I mean by that is on match column color, if you want to do all black, make a big old square, you can, but that doesn't look as kind of sexy and cool. So what you can do is match the column color. And then when you go to the color of the column, instead of having it be full blown the color, just make it a little lighter, the more transparent. It's going to show through now. These subtle things, that's the first tip. All right, now I'm going on through 2 through 5. The cluster chart updates. They have updated these suckers to do much more. Following in line with what they've already done with the column charts, the stacked version of column charts. So we're going to talk through all of these things. Space between series, overlap, flip overlap, sort by value. Also, there's a Power BI blog. I'll put the link in this description as well. That will talk you through these updates too. It's very helpful. Now for the clustered charts. Let's click into this and let's get into what these things are doing. So these new features are going to be found in the section for columns. So if we decrease these, what we're going to see first is we have a layout. And under this section is where these new things are going to be. So for this example, we're just going to make a chart and I will talk you through it. So if I take this, it's always good to learn. This is where you can follow along. So I'm going to make it very simple. Take the net sales, and we're going to chop this up by date. And we're going to have it be a clustered chart. And we're going to have the legend be the product category. Simple. Okay, now let's drill down. As you click into the hierarchy, this is kind of the default, what this thing looks like. So I'm going to remove quarter, and we'll remove year and remove day. And I'll make this chart on the right-hand side look like the chart on the left-hand side. So again, this is how cluster charts used to look. You know, you have the value. I'll make the values the same. So let's look at the, we'll get into more detail here, but first, to set the column, set the colors in the column section, you're always going to be able to alter the series by either everything, which is what we're going to do in part two of this, but or specifically, which is what we can do now for like colors. So let's set these colors to be the same. Office 365, I want that color to be this blue-purple color. The Power Platform, we'll keep it yellow. Power BI all the way. Xbox, let's make it green. So now these are the same, but oh my gosh, they look so much different. So how in the world do we make these things look better? I'm going to show you right now. So what we can do is, this one's actually doing the sales number, so I'm going to take this off and put sales on there so it just matches. All right, so here are the new features for the space between series, the overlapping, and how to get something cool like this. Notice it's much bigger on the left-hand side, but the bars take up less space as well. It just looks cool. This is a subtle improvement. It's huge. So what we're going to do is go to the column section. You must pick the series to be everything. Series all. Now under the layout section, we're going to expand the layout section. This is where the new stuff resides. This is where the new stuff is for cluster charts. This is what we're going to dive into. So what that looks like are these features. First, if we turn on overlap, nothing quite happens right now. So why not? Let's look into this. This is where you can now start gauging and changing these things up. So this is like your dials. So because I turned on overlap, now the space between the series, you can see I am decreasing the space between the series by changing this percentage here and getting these things a little fatter. Space between categories, if I decrease this, you can see these are getting more tweaked up, and you can just dial this sucker in to make these things look cool. Now here's the additional tweaks, which are always nice. So you can sort by the value, and we'll pick something where we can see that. So what I mean is if we, let's pick maybe one that might be a little different, click around till we see something like this. Okay. So we see that March. Now let's go back to the layout of this chart. And if we look at the sort by value, we have it sort by value on. And what that is showing, let's turn these data labels on so we can get a gist. Those data labels don't look good, but we're going to format them as well. This will just help. So for this section, what's in front is dynamic. So what's in front right here is this Power Platform, the yellow. But over here, it's Xbox. So it actually is going to put the order of how these things are sorted from front to back in sort by value. If I turn this off, you can see it reverts it. See that? Watch March. There, reverts it. So when you get more values, these things will really flip-flop all around. Also, maybe you want to have a reverse order. So now we're just kind of staggering them from left to right, right to left. I like this way. But then also, you can flip the overlap. So right now I have the small stuff in front. Maybe I want to have the big stuff. Maybe you do, maybe you don't. It's typical to have the bigger in the back. Tall people, you know, put them in the back, they can see. So now we have this shaped up. We can change all the different space between the series, space between the categories, get this going. This is a quick tip I'm going to throw in for data labels. I have a whole other video on data labels, but if you want to understand how to make them better, don't just let them float around like this. This looks bad. Look over here. This is a quick idea, but what you can always do, and it's a new feature from December as well, is you can tweak the data levels for every single series. So maybe you want to get real creative. And for example, I'll just start this by saying we want to have the background on, make it a little less transparent, and let's make the value stand out. Okay, cool. But now let's say we want to just get a little funky with it. If you want to get in here and tweak stuff up, you can always change things for the series based upon what you select. So if we pick office, now maybe we want to change this up where the value itself, you know, it's going to be purple, and you can go through it. Same with background. Background, maybe make that purple and make this then white. And the goal of what I'm doing here is you can change the subtleness of these backgrounds to match what it is showing on the column. And that is going to allow you the subtle thing to make this look better. Look, it takes 2 seconds. I'll do the rest of this. So if you come back over here, I'm going to pick now the apply settings to Power Platform. Go to the background section. I want this to be the yellow. And now look, it's coming to life. Very simple. Come back up here. Go to Xbox. Go back down to the background. Change this up. If you say, well, what if you have a bunch? If you have more than 5 categories, you have the wrong chart. You don't need to have that many chart categories. It's going to be too cluttered. But look at this. See, even from left to right, the subtle differences of how these labels look so much cooler when you do additional formatting to make them look good. So big release for the clustered format. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. The first one was number 5, and now final number 6. This looks awesome, man. This is the new feature for when you can just turn on ribbons for any bar chart, any chart you've got going on. So what does that look like? In the section now, and you can tweak it, man. You can get deep with these filters. So for example, I'm going to turn on there's nothing here, but if you turn on the ribbons, it's going to essentially take that color and trace it, the color. So it's really cool as you start moving things around. You know, on the left, I can see office over here. It swings up, had the most. Oh, it swings back down. Okay, now it's here. So you can see the movement of things. You can trace this along. But what they've done, it's not just a simple on-off button. It's actually a deep control that you have to, you can pick specific series, edit certain ribbon colors, whatever. So I'll show you. Say we want to trace. We'll trace the Power Platform just because, you know, man, Power BI is the best. So I'm going to come over here and pick Power Platform. Now I can tweak these suckers up. So what if I say, I don't actually want the color to match the series. If you do, you can turn it on, you can turn it off, but I'll pick this color to be red or something crazy. But then what I can do is continue this down, make the transparency even less. You can really look at this thing. Again, this is supposed to be intended to show you how to set things up so you can just format them on your own. But all this ribbon functionality, it's super new. And it's gonna allow you to do cool, cool stuff. Because in the ribbon, every ribbon also has a border. So even within this now, maybe I wanna kinda tie it back. So I'm gonna make a yellow border. It's looking pretty nasty, but it's a way just to show you what these features can do. So you can get in here and tweak these things out, man, to get a ribbon that you want to trace these things through. And then as people interact with your dashboards, look at that. You can really see what's happening. If you want to get even crazier, you can control every single border around the blocks as well. So maybe just for this fun little exercise, if I come up into here and go to the, we'll go to the column. I'll come back into this. And let's keep tweaking this column. So I'll go to the bar, but now Power Platform. Well, let's get this border to have it almost take on that red. So don't match the bar color. I'm going to set red. And now it's even kind of just going the whole flow through this thing. And again, you can just get in here and tweak all the settings. Again, this doesn't look good right here, but it's intended just to show you how they've given us all this control. So this is all came out in February. There's going to be more and more updates every month. I will make sure you understand what they are. I've already released 2 other videos about dynamic automatic visual calculations, these new calculations, as well as dynamic subscriptions, and now all 6 of these features. So every update, you're going to get the best info. If you have any questions, comments, leave them. I'll be happy to help you. Take care. Enjoy Power BI. Later.